Here's today's controversial question for those of you that are AR shooters. Does the wiggle that you get between the upper receiver and the lower receiver actually affect the precision of the rifle? As I've shot this rifle over 7 years, there's definitely some wiggle that's built up. It started out tight as, well, you fill in the blank, but over time, I can get some audible wiggle, and I can actually see some light coming through the gap between the two receivers. There are two camps on this issue. There are those that say that everything needs to be as tight as possible in order to get good precision out of a rifle, and you're going to get a lot of the bolt action guys coming from this school. They spend a lot of time making sure that there are perfect mating surfaces between their actions and stocks, and they're definitely not going to want any kind of movement, rattle, or anything in their rifles. And then you're going to have the other school of thought that says that there is no significant movement between the barrel, upper receiver, before the bullet actually leaves the muzzle. And we're going to be testing all this with the X-Shim. This came to me from Brad down in Texas, and he makes these things. His website is varmintlights.com. And what these do is they take up the gap between the receivers at the front and the rear, just little shims that that fill in the gap there. And we're going to be testing this not just for aesthetics, you know, does it remove the rattle, does it just take up that gap and make everything feel all nice and new again. We're also going to test the precision of the rifle with and without the shims, and we'll see how this thing does. Now before we go any further, be sure to subscribe to the Social Regressive. We have some interesting projects in the works. We're still kind of in that build where we're turning a Savage Axis into a long-range precision rifle, and that's going really well. We've shot it in one 600-yard match, and things went pretty well, but I gotta tell you that things are getting very interesting. I've made some changes to the rifle, and it is shooting a lot better. So the next match that I go to, I intend to score much higher. I really think I will. And then if you like us on Facebook, we have some behind-the-scenes content. You can connect with other people that are interested in the same stuff. If you have any weird questions about things that I've done, you can put them there. This playlist down here actually goes to that Savage Axis build. So if you want to see some of the stuff that went on there, it's really a pretty fascinating build, and it came out very well. Some of you are already familiar with the accu-wedge, which is a somewhat flexible wedge that you stuff at the back of the receiver, and it tightens up the connection just by squishing against the rear lug. The X-Shim takes a different approach. It uses a set of color-coded shims that fit over the action lugs, and that bridges the gap between the two receivers. One of the biggest differences between the two products is the fact that you can shim the front of the receiver as well as the back with the X-Shim. And another difference is the type of material that's used. The accu-wedge is very dense, but it is still compressible. And the X-Shim uses a specialized plastic that resists compression. And the maker also claims that it resists damage from solvents and oils that we use to clean our weapons. Installation takes a few minutes. There are 4 shim thicknesses included in each pack, and each color-coded plate includes a rear shim, a front shim, and a test shim. I'm starting at the rear, and then I'm clamping down on each of these test shims. I'm trying to find the perfect thickness that will take out the wobble, but will still allow the pins to go home. Shim number 4 seems to work really well, so now I'll move forward and I'll test that front gap. And again, it looks like gauge 4 is our perfect fit. This thin wall goes toward the rear. It says to slide the thin side down first, then push down the front. And this little tab at the front, it doesn't actually fit into anything. There's nothing to clip onto or anything like that. It's just there for retention to keep the shim in place. Now this one doesn't have any kind of retention. There's no tab or anything going on here. So if you are doing a full takedown, then yeah, this is probably going to drop free.
that's not that common in the field, I'm sure. You know, mostly you're just going to be dropping your rear pin so that you can access your bolt or whatever. After a little trial and error, there was still just a little bit of wobble, so what I ended up doing is using number 4 at the back, and then at the front, I stacked two different ones. I have number 4 and number 3. To find out if the X-Shims affect the performance of the rifle, I'll be shooting two 5-shot groups without the shims and two with the shims. Distance is 100 yards, and I'm shooting prone with the rifle on a bipod. The test loads are my varminting hand loads. This is Lake City Brass, CCI Primers, Varget Powder, and at the front I have Mid-South Varmint Nightmare Extreme 55 grain hollow point flat base bullets. These first two groups are without the X-Shims, and the first one came in at nearly 1¾ inches. The second one opened up to nearly 2 inches. With the shims in place, these two groups tighten things up a bit. The first group comes in a bit over 1½ inches, and group 2 drops things down to 1¼ inches.
At the very least, the X-Shim did take the wobble and rattle out of the connection between the two receivers. It really does sound and feel like a new rifle again. But did it actually increase the precision of the rifle? Even though we only did these 4 back-to-back group tests, I think that the indications are pretty good. I think that it actually did tighten up the functionality of the rifle. And I'm really curious to hear from those of you that are using either the accu-wedge or X-Shim or anything like that. Have you seen any gains in the precision of your rifles? Leave a comment down below.